Well, hello everyone, Paul Akers, Norman Bodak. We're en route back to the airport. We finished our amazing trip to TVS Motors and SST, and we just want to reflect on what we've learned because it's been a pretty incredible week. What do you think, Norman?
I think it's been fabulous. I mean, just plain fabulous. First of all, Paul has changed my life, completely changed my life. I lost already maybe 5-6 pounds this week. I got a whole new set of clothes.
And he looks awesome, too.
I have a whole new diet of the foods I'm eating. And I'm going
to And you're going to the bathroom regular. Everything's perfect, right?
Everything is just wonderful.
You're going to quit taking all those vitamins and medicines and all those supplements. You don't have to take anything anymore.
We had a fabulous week. And, we'll summarize the whole week with you. But today, we met with the chairman of this $2 billion company, TVS. And he runs this fabulous charity. We'll tell you more about that. Called Srinivasan Services Trust, or SST. It is so unique in the world of what this charity does. So unique, because you know the old adage that you can give a man food, you can give him fish, or you can teach him how to fish. If you give him food, he's hungry the next day. If you teach him how to fish, he can take care of himself the rest of his life. Well, Vina with SST teaches people how to fish. Teaches people how to be self-reliant. We'll talk more about that.
But not on a small scale. 2 million people. You've seen the video.
It's incredible.
3,500 villages.
3,500 villages. That's crazy. Been into close to 2 million people that they've been affecting already. His goal is to raise it to 10,000 villages. So he wants to go, close to 8 to 10 million people in India. And also he wants to enlist companies like him that will take over and do the same thing. And it's not complicated, it's just being dedicated.
Oh, it's so simple, the model's beautiful.
The model is beautiful. I mean, they're such geniuses. I know of so many. In fact, last year, I gave to 100 different charities. And most, if not all of these charities just give to people, but
and keep them dependent.
And keep them dependent. Keep them dependent so the charity can continue.
And this is the real test of a charity, if they ask for money. He doesn't even ask for money. They don't need money.
No,
you imagine that? Because the model works so perfect. He does this about $1.5 million a year it costs him for this program, which is dirt cheap for affecting
Amazing
2 million people.
Doing. Absolutely.
And it just keeps spreading. So let's talk a little bit about what you and I have learned on this trip, because we both started off the video in the very beginning that both of our lives were going to be changed, and certainly mine was. So I'm going to start off with me, okay?
Go ahead.
So number one, I came on this trip because I wanted to be around Norman. I wanted to learn from him. He's 83 years old. He's traveled the world, built multi-million dollar companies, and been so incredibly successful. And I just wanted to have the opportunity to learn from him and listen to his wisdom. And indeed, that's what happened, because we spoke all the time. I recorded a whole series of videos on Norman. You're going to be able to hear those. I think there are 6 episodes now that will be launched on the American Innovator. You'll be able to hear all the stories and all the great people that Norman has been around his whole life, because he's been with the top leaders in the world. And he's shared that with me, and I've learned about that experience. So number one, the first thing I learned is to be bold. And most people say, well, Paul, you're already pretty bold. Well, you know what? I'm not even remotely bold compared to Norman, because he's not afraid to go up to the chairman of the board of Southwest Airlines or the Marriott Hotels, or ask the president of the United States to speak at his conference, which he did, Ronald Reagan. And the list goes on and on and on. All the great leaders Norman had at his conferences. So I learned, first and foremost, stop being afraid. You can do way more than you ever thought. And Norman considers himself just kind of like an average guy, right? And yet you pull off all these amazing things.
A number of years back, I love Chinese food. And I'm very careful when I get the fortune cookie. I want to get a good one. I'm serious. And I study it. I'm trying to get intuitive. And I picked this out. And it said, you have the talent to recognize the talent in others. That's my talent, to recognize the talent in others. And that's how I'm attracted to Paul, because he's such an unusual talent. And when I was very young, I was very afraid, very, very much afraid to reach out to people that were distinguished, that were famous, that were rich. That barrier is gone. All of my fears are gone.
He has no fears.
No.
You're going after Zuckerberg now, right?
I want to go after Zuckerberg.
Because he wants Zuckerberg to support SST and to move into this, because the model's
amazing. Even more so, I really want to get SST the Nobel Prize. I tried.
This is the way this man thinks. This is what I learned on this trip.
I tried to get Shingo the Nobel Prize, but I couldn't reach them. They weren't smart enough to realize that
the genius
that
Shingo was.
That man changed the economy. They have an economic prize, and that man changed the economy of the world more than anybody.
And still does. And still continues to change with all the knowledge of lean that's been spread.
It is amazing because it's come from. Lean came from just two people. It came from Ono and it came from Shingo.
And I want to interject here so everyone understands the context. It was Norman who's considered the father of lean in the United States because he recognized this talent in Japan and brought all these masters to the United States and published their books and translated them, then brought this knowledge to the corporations in the U.S. and basically transformed the U.S. Business climate because of what he had the vision to do. So why I say my first thing that I learned was boldness.
Well, my main vision was just to go after these geniuses. I'm very grateful that I wasn't hesitant and wasn't afraid. And we sat today with the chairman of this company, Vainu, and he was so wonderful. I mean, just so wonderful.
So gracious. I mean, so gracious, approachable. You know? We had probably had a total of maybe 9 hours with him, 8 to 9 hours.
It was just wonderful being with him. And in retrospect, you know, he told me, Norman, I read all of your books over the years, and that's like 250 books.
Brilliant
and
man.
And he spent one of the key books he read, he's the second person to tell me this, was the Cannon Production System. That goes back into the early 1980s. One of the first books I published was the Cannon Production System. And that was key for him to learn. Even before we learned all about Toyota, Cannon had its act together. And in some ways, Canon is even more advanced than Toyota today. They really are. Toyota still has people working on the line, doing repetitive tasks one over the other. You go to Canon and they have what's called a Supermeister system. Meister meaning master, German word meaning master. They have people that can make the whole product. They can, instead of doing what they do in almost every company in manufacturing,
break it all down,
repeat it over and over and over again into very simple steps, you know, as if people don't have minds. A Canon worker will spend 3 hours making the whole copier all by themselves. It's a fantastic system. And so the Canon production system was the forerunner of that. And I was so happy to hear Vainu talk about the Canon production
system. Yeah, the depth of this man is incredible. So now, but I want to transition because that's all fantastic. But what did you learn and what did I learn? The first thing I learned was to be much more bold than I am and to have a much bigger vision because of you. The second thing I learned was about meditation because one of the things Norman wanted me to do was to meditate because, you know, I'm all over the board. You know, my mind goes a million miles an hour. If anybody's ever been around me, you know, I'm all over the place. And Norman says, you know, you got to take some time to be still. So Norman said, if you could just meditate for 10 minutes a day, that would be great, Paul. But I did it for 20 minutes every day. I got up at 5 o'clock in the morning, meditated basically from 5:30, from 5 to 5:30. And I sat on the floor very quietly and just really breathed more than anything else and just was quiet. And your quote on that, what do you say really understanding is the ability to the stilled mind? How do you say it?
The mind is so busy. The mind is so busy all the time. And we're listening to that mind as if it knows anything. I mean, what it knows is your past. It really doesn't know the present. And so how do you get the mind quiet so you can really live in the present?
In the moment.
Which is very, very powerful. And so if you could really learn how to meditate, go deeply inside yourself, instead of listening to this crazy mind, which is always chattering, you're attempting to dive down into your deeper self or your higher self.
Into your soul.
You can call it the soul. I call it the higher self. Soul is a good word because it's available to you all the time if you can quiet your mind. But people don't quiet the mind. It's always struggling to give you what you want. The Bible says, ask and I shall receive, but we don't know how to ask. So, I mean, it was just wonderful. This is a funny part of the story, though. I've been meditating for over 40 years. Meditating and reading everything. All you tell me the literature, the Bible, the Koran, I've literally read everything, and I've been fascinating with India, with Buddhism, with Hinduism.
Your mind is always thinking about the past, and it's always thinking about the future, but it's rarely settled on the moment. And so I learned to settle on the moment. It was powerful for me, and I would never exchanged this last week for anything. So that's what I took away, along with so many other things I learned about TVS Motors, the operational excellence there, and SST, the vision for helping people who are impoverished be educated and be lifted up. Now, what did you learn?
I've changed one. First of all, I have a new diet, right? I follow this Paul and his Lean Health. So I no longer eat potatoes, I no longer eat the spaghetti, I eat no rolls. And the biggest thing that he got me to surrender was the fabulous cakes. This hotel makes
pretty tempting.
Makes the best pastries. I stopped having them. I'm lucky I came the day for him, because at least I had one day with him. But now I've totally changed. I've totally learned.
And how do you feel?
I feel wonderful.
Yeah?
I'm losing weight. I feel better in so many respects.
Okay, so you feel like the one thing you've changed is your health is improving.
Much better.
Okay. Well, I'm going to end it right there, unless you have something else profound you want to tell about what you learned. But at the end of the day, it was a great week.
Oh, yeah.
We had a great time.
Yeah.
Irreplaceable in knowledge and experience. And hopefully you'll see us again in India sometime in the near future.
I hope. And it's a miracle. I don't know why. I really don't know why. But Venu has asked me to come back at the end of July.
Awesome.
And I'm sure they're going to ask Paul to come back too.
No, they don't want me.
Because Paul has done some magic putting this under video. And yeah. as we spoke with him, we get him to rethink his life.
Absolutely. So this is an important thing to note. And then we're going to close it. We have to.
Just,
I captured Venu on video for about an hour and a half today, telling the story of his life, the business, his wisdom, and we'll break that up into about 8 different American innovators that you can watch in maybe 10-minute segments, so you can see how powerful and knowledgeable and thoughtful this man is.
This is very interesting too, because I've been studying yoga, meditation for 40 years. I finally said, I have a teacher, I really respect this man. And I said to him, I'd really love to teach. I've never done this before. And he says, Norman, yes, I think you're ready to teach. But just be careful, you only teach what you know, number one. And then I knew that my first student was going to be Paul Akers, even before I got
to
India.
I'm the guinea pig.
And now I think my second student is going to be Venu Srinivasan.
Which is awesome.
Because I said to him, you have to meditate. And he agreed with me.
And he used to do it, but he's not doing it now. So it's been an epic week. So thanks a lot for watching and listening.
Thank you very much.
Hopefully this all helps you. Talk to you soon.
Hope so.
Live from India.
Bye.